two, three, fire!
Four. Dude, that was freaking awesome, dude. Oh, man, dude. Dude, we've been waiting for so long for this, and we finally got it. Brand new hero, Egyptian hero. And I was freaking right about him, you know, switching the two different stances, you know. Him having, you know, as a polo on, and then switched it to
what an amazing
double,
trailer. Oh, my God, I'm so excited. That was so great. I have somebody guests with me today. So, Stefanian, Andrew, Anastasia, welcome to the Warriors Den. Welcome to live. First time for all the way for Warriors Den and live as well.
Wait, you said live? This is live?
Yes, it's live.
We're live, guys.
What? Yeah, so I hope you're
not... We are live.
Thank you for having me. Thrilled to be here, too.
It's going to be a great show. So, we'll dive into Medjay right now. So, Stefan, tell us about Medjay. Tell us about, like, the creation of this hero.
Absolutely. Really excited to bring you the Medjay hero, the Egyptian warrior. Basically, we know that the Outlanders have kind of opened up the world. The pirates opened up the seas. We've opened up the Lost Horizons. And now we have the opportunity to have fighters from all around the world enter for honor. So this is awesome. Thank you to the Outlanders.
Kind of like it how you have the regular armor on him, so and then you have the other armor right there.
Basically, it gives us two major kind of opportunities.
Oh, what the hell?
Heroes from any individual culture in
the world. Oh, I did that on their side.
And then, of course,
I was about to say, did my headphones go
for Egypt, everybody. So this is our first on our hit parade, basically.
Yeah, and they bring, I guess, with them different style of gameplay as well, unique stuff, right?
Absolutely. That's the other kind of, like, core feature, really, of the Outlanders, is, like, what's, like, a unique gameplay opportunity for each.
Uh-oh. Oh, no. They're having technical difficulties. But, you know,
And we have the props.
I can excuse them because, you know, it's been 2 years since they, you know, done it live.
As well, so it's,
you know,
8 feet long.
A live, Warriors Den.
Connect.
Because in the past we've had, of course, you know, pre-recorded, so.
Oh, that was so much better than
almost
practice.
Almost as fast as we die. There very you nice. Go. So there's a magnet in it, but yeah. So yeah, that's great. I mean, it's fun to have a weapon and a play style really different for this hero.
Absolutely. I mean, like, you might know, like, Highlander gets knocked out of its second form all the time. Yep. This character gets to sit in it, in locked, all they want. So it's
I can wait to dive more into gameplay later. But let's talk about the history of the character and the archetype. Like, who is Medjay?
Working on the Medjay was a huge challenge, a very fun challenge, but hugely challenging because there are two fighting styles. And so this created twice the work for all departments. When it came time to craft the archetype backstory, we knew that the weapon
the
was
the eve of
the
battle,
point.
A great pharaoh whose name has long
for
been
the hero
forgotten
goes
once
that
said,
they developed this
give
new
me a dozen of my loyal Medjay over an army
invaders,
and now shall win
because,
the day.
They are a lost civilization of Egypt. Unfortunately, in For Honor universe, Egypt's been destroyed in the cataclysm. And so all these invaders want to come in now and pillage the remnants.
Dude, the Medjay, I don't know, he reminds me so much of a wrestler for some reason.
They have two twin axes, which makes them a bit speedier in fights. They can instantly
reattach
it.
Actually,
he does
kind of remind me of...
for group fights, because that has a bit more of a wider reach. Yeah, and so this makes them incredibly elite, deadly warriors.
A little bit reminds me of Shelton
really
Benjamin.
Remarkable about the Medjay is that
either Shelton Benjamin or Bobby Lashley.
Driven by a crow.
That's what he reminds me of.
Really not
going
to kill unless absolutely necessary to protect the innocent.
And for people who are wrestling fans, hopefully you know those names.
To the gameplay,
so,
to the weapon, to the fighting style. So
and I am a wrestling fan too.
And the weapon as well. So
that's how I know those names.
Let's dive into the character itself, Jan. So what can
oh my god, this way. Oh my god, he does look like Bobby Lashley.
So Neferkel is our main Medjay. He's the last descendant of the pharaohs, and he's the leader of the Medjay as a group. Now, as Andre said, in the world of For Honor, Egypt prospered a long time ago, but it was destroyed during the cataclysm. So now it's left nothing but, you know, desert sands and fallen ruins and all that. So the Medjay are like the last defenders of their culture. They keep that history alive through them. And Neferka is the
oh, that's his
leader
name?
Of that whole endeavor.
Neferka.
And now, Nefertica. As you know, part of those relics, there is the Scarab bracelet. Mm-hmm. And if that name sounds familiar,
Bolthorn.
It's because it was the Star of TU1.
It was a relic that
Bolthorn, the Viking, stole from the temple. Now, here's the thing about Bolthorn and Nefertica is that when Bolthorn ventured in the desert, he crossed paths with Nefertica. Nefertica was on to him.
Also, they met for real.
Nefertica saw him go into the temple, and
we heard about this when we got the teaser.
Try to protect their treasures.
The teaser of it.
And like, we got the nice
other side of the story. Fortunately,
Bolthorn had
perspective of the new Egyptian hero.
He betrayed Nefertica's trust, stole the bracelet, and took it back.
The Medjay.
And brought the curse with him
He brought the curse with him as well.
I feel like it's a sad friendship story.
It's a super sad friendship story. It's actually inspired by Andre and I.
Oh, really?
Yeah. That's
how you met, guys?
Yeah, absolutely.
Wow. But we saw the fight in the trailer
exactly.
as well.
Exactly. So Nefertica is like, Bolthorn, you kind of deserve this for doing what you did, but also, like, too many people are going to die, and being the noble hero that he is, he travels to Heathmoor.
Save us all.
Yeah, and then this big fight between the two takes place.
Oh my god, I love it. So, bringing the ancient Egypt into the world of Heathmoor, what was it for? Because it's a real place. So, what was it for historically
just looks
speaking?
Just like a freaking comic, dude. I like how it kind of looks like a comic book.
As I go on about that, just stop me if it gets a bit boring. When we did our research, we realized
boring.
Okay. the original meaning for Medjay was. It meant someone who came from the land of Medja in Nubia, which is a region along the Nile River. But over time, this meaning changes. It comes to mean a desert ranger because the Medjay become the elite police force in Egypt. And they're the guards, and they really contribute to making Egypt the superpower of its day. And so the pharaohs tasked them with guarding the most valuable places in Egypt, temples, tombs, the borders. And so they're incredibly well-respected elite warriors. And this peaks around the 18th dynasty. Unfortunately, by the 20th dynasty, their names disappear from the records. And we don't really know what happens to them, which is a shame. But their names will forever live on as elite warriors.
It's crazy how many, like, research you guys had to do to create this hero and to make it, like, feel real.
Respect to the Medjay.
So, going into Heart right now, Art, Andrew, Anastasia. So, Andrew, what can you tell us about the creation of this hero, artistically speaking, sir?
Thank you.
Artistic.
The Medjay, Nefertica, is a quite special character in For Honor history because we started with the knight, Viking, and samurai, three specific cultures, mm-hmm. As a faction, and then a year after we introduced Wulin as a different culture.
Yeah, Martian
after
Fire.
That, we were maintaining within this four different cultures, and then went on for about four. Then fifth year, we introduced the Outlander, hinting that there's some other cultures existing outside.
Earlier this year, they introduced
fact,
them.
Medjay is a quite special and meaningful character because he gives us a possibility. He shows the possibility that there's other cultures, other warriors that is existing from other country, which makes our map was flat, but now it's not. It's a round.
Well, the world is not flat.
Either or not, it is a round.
Sorry, what?
The world is not. The world is round.
What?
Breaking
round,
news.
Oh no!
But not only that.
Is this argument that people say that the Earth is flat?
This
and
culture
it's not round.
It's quite exciting. It's a new culture, Egypt, and people.
I don't deal with that
us,
shit. I'm good.
New style, new pattern, new silhouette. New. Everything was quite new. So the team it kind of brought us a fresh wind to the Bronner team.
Yeah.
But as excited as it was for. For reality, it was a tough. There was a lot of challenges that we had to do because it's a new culture that we had to adopt it into foreigner world. Mm-hmm. So it's not something that current or ancient Egypt just to bring it to the foreigner. We had to retranslate it. So that was a quite good challenge, but then it was quite exciting. But enough of that. Let's take a look at the concept art.
Yes, we do have concept. It's been a while.
Hey,
it's been 2 years, I think.
Yeah. Oh
so
my god.
Here's the concept
damn,
art of Medjay. This is deep.
Really?
Set.
Has it been
he's
yeah,
a confident
I think it's been
character.
2 years.
He's a strong, muscular,
and
he's a massive.
Because I don't think
you
Griffin
don't
got a card in the vault. The
pirate
didn't get one. Kyoshin and Warmonger. The last one they got the constant art was actually
protecting his
Zhang Hu
people and the innocent people. So
was it Zhang Hu or was it?
And also, he's
you
a
don't elite, don't warrior. It's been
same
so long.
Time he's a warrior bloodline. So mm-hmm. his armor has sophisticated decorations and engravings and patterns were applied onto the characters. Structure-wise, we made sure to start with the Egyptian regular trendy traditional outfits. Mm-hmm. But then on top of that, we left enough room for concept artists to research to make them invite into the For Honor and then retranslate it so he fits into our game. But fashion was amazing. The research in the Egypt was quite exciting, but that's not the only thing that was exciting. The other one that was catching our eyes was a mythology.
Yes.
So let's take a look at the set too.
Anubis!
I mean,
that's so great. That's
so great.
So second set was something.
And this is what some people have been wanting. People wanted a Anubis mask for the characters, and you know they finally got one. So awesome.
Figurative.
So these are the two Anubis sets that we have. We have the regular version.
There's Anubis inspiration,
and we have this version
and the soul bag and Osiris.
So I guess we're not gonna have a third one.
I mean,
so I guess the main one.
We're gonna take a look at all the variations.
I guess the first one just sucks.
Stand out pretty well in the battlefield. But
we're gonna see a lot of those in the battlefield for sure.
I mean, you see that coming for you. Just run away.
But during the Warrior Stand, we usually don't show the back part of it. So here's the turntable that we prepare for you. So
3D model.
A sneak peek of how it's going to look on the back side of
that
it.
That looks so great.
The whole concept team did amazing.
I know there are going to be some people that are going to be complaining that, he doesn't have any armor on his chest or on his back.
It's really an exceptional job.
That's how it is. Okay. Oh, he has it right here.
I love the color. I love the pop of color. A little bit like the... I love it. Yeah, the texture, the gold. I don't know. It's
not the only armor variations that's going to be standing out.
Mm-hmm.
That this character has something very special, as we introduced at the beginning. What's that? The weapon.
The weapon. Yes, Anastasia. Tell us more about the weapon and the design of the weapon, because I see that it's pretty intricate.
So we got to look at the armor sets. Now we get to look at the weapon sets.
As it was mentioned before, now we have this two-sided fan axe that can be turned into two axes.
Fan axe or palm axe. Either way,
it was pretty challenging for our team to make it look great and also believable. That it makes sense, and you can actually have it in real life. We did. So the tricky part was these handles that have to be connected with the special lock, and our team did a great job in designing this special lock.
Okay.
For that. So here we can see the evolution of this weapon. We're starting with original Medjay weapon that was inherited by his ancestors, and while we're moving, we see that the shape is getting more and more complicated. We see more interesting patterns and different designs that was inspired by Egyptian mythology.
Oh, the one with the scorpion. Look at that.
The epic.
The one with
weapons,
the scorpion.
The
one with the Anubis
the
one.
The epic weapons is Egyptian gods. Mm-hmm. And
the one with the pharaoh.
Some, history moments that happened in Medjay's history.
Oh.
Yes.
Ooh, look at the snake.
Now you can see my favorite one.
I'm guessing that's a cobra.
Yes.
Oh, I love it. The character is great. The conception of this character, the weapon. But you spoke about armor variation, Andrew. Can we see them?
Of course.
Oh,
let's roll.
Let's roll.
Wait.
As Steph mentioned, this time we are having two sets.
I guess we all get more armor
variations each, and three variations will have alternate.
I guess Stefan was right when he said there's going to be more stuff to come. So we have the regular version. The one without the helmet, but he has patterns on his chest.
Play and customize in different ways because the one and the other has a different options on it. It's a fantastic fashion that they have it, and of course, as we go through, we'll be able to see all these gods.
So you have one with the paint, one without the paint.
But the presentation.
Not bad.
I really love it. Oh my god.
Oh, so what
it's
the?
It's funny, Anastasia, because you mentioned the intricate part, and that was part of the first conversation we had, because we had to make it like,
dude, that is cool
for gameplay purposes.
He's basically a mummy.
Also makes sense. So
that's
this
awesome.
One has magnets. So I don't know if they have magnets. Andrew, maybe not.
It's another one of the Medjay secrets.
Okay.
How it works.
Yeah. Okay. So he brought magnet into Hint more. So we used that, but at first we used
the
twist.
One.
But I mocap it just didn't work out really well. So that was a bit weird to handle as well. So. Wow. Oh, that's the which god is that? Is
Anubis.
Wow.
Another.
So you have one Anubis mask as the.
Something that we're doing this time around is that on the Hero
without.
Page website. Mm-hmm. On the website, we'll have a list of all the weapon names and as well as the lore description. So people
Crocodile
get to know
helm.
Why they're called what they're called. It
nice.
Gives a bit of context to the weapons.
And one with paint, one without
history
paint.
As well.
I love more lore attached to a weapon because I feel like you, when you choose it, it's not only visual. It's like the backstory. So you're like more into it because you choose the weapon.
Oh, that's...
So
exactly,
do you have a favorite one?
Yeah, my favorite one is, we call it the Nightclaws. And it's basically the weapon that was wielded by this sort of like Black Ops team of Medjay that the pharaohs would send to execute specific targets.
Okay, so Stefan was...
I love it. So guys, we're going to gameplay.
He didn't say we're going to get two armor sets.
Thank you so much for coming
but we got armor variations.
Don't
so
forget
I guess,
the hero will be available.
That's still awesome,
July 28th.
Even though some of the armor still look the same, but the helmets look a lot different. So
after 2 weeks. So thank you so much, guys.
Thank you for having us.
And we'll see you soon for more gameplay stuff.
At least we got different armor variations, so... kind of cool about that. I mean, we get to play as a mummy, so that's awesome. We have the Anubis, of course, you know, Anubis helm. We have a crocodile helm or alligator, don't know which one it is. We have the war helm, and really, really cool, dude. Awesome.